protect yourself from falling luggage and always leave your laptop behind. Experts reveal how to survive a plane crash. The odds of being in a plane crash are 1 in every 1.2 million flights, but if you do happen to be unlucky, there are some measures that you can take to improve your chances of survival. A former United Airlines stewardess has been sharing her tips on what to do if a flight starts to head south unintentionally. The advice includes protecting yourself from falling luggage, keeping carry-on items beneath your seat, and picking a good brace position. Know where you are. Schwartz said, "I don't care if you have flown in 747s for decades, they are not all the same. Each time you take your seat, you must count the number of rows between your seat and the nearest exits in front of you and behind you on the left and the right. Know how to open the exits." Schwartz said, "The safety cards show you how to open the doors and whether or not you need to take an extra step to deploy the slide. Know how to open the windows over the wing and how to get out. Know how to pick the best brace position." Schwartz said, "If you have a seat in front of you, cross your hands on that seat back in front of you and rest your forehead on top of your crossed hands. You are going to flail around during a crash, but with your head supported in front of you, your flailing distance is lessened and you have less chance of head and neck whiplash injuries. If there is no seat in front of you, bend over as far as you can and grab your legs behind your knees. And, of course, keep your seat belt tight, tight, tight. Protect yourself from falling luggage." Schwartz said, "Protect your head, neck and back with a blanket, jacket, coat or whatever you have to dampen the blow of overhead baggage flying out and down upon you and the ceiling falling apart. Keep carry-on luggage under the seat in front." Schwartz said, "If your bag is under the seat in front of you, that will be one less bag crashing down on you. More important, the luggage under the seat in front of you will act as a barrier for your feet and legs. It will keep you from shooting out from under your seat belt and sliding into the space under the seat in front of you where your legs, feet, and ankles will be broken. Your broken body can't escape. Leave your carry-on luggage and computer at your seat during evacuation." Schwartz said, "Stuff can be replaced. You can't convince me that anything you own is more important than getting your life saved. If I see you trying to come down the aisle with a computer, I'll rip it out of your hands, and if another passenger is trying to evacuate and is blocked by your computer, he'll rip it out of your hands. We have 90 seconds to evacuate 600 passengers or 30 passengers. We have trained and know how to do it, and your carry-on doesn't fit into the mix. Get your body out of your seat, head to the closest exit that is available. Not all of the ones you chose before you took off may be available, as there might be fire at one, or water at another. But a hole in the fuselage may have opened up and that now counts as an exit, and get out. Help others if you can. Then run away and keep running far away from the aircraft in case of explosion." Schwartz said, "Most crashes are survivable. Yet, with survivable crashes, crash scene investigators find passengers without a scratch on them still belted in their seats, dead. Sometimes the passenger was just waiting for someone to individually tell them to unbuckle his seatbelt and get out, or they had no idea what to do. This is why knowing what to do before you take off is necessary. Or perhaps the dead passengers experienced negative panic and just froze in their seats. We are trained to re-enter a crashed airplane to rescue passengers like this. The first officer also goes through the plane looking for passengers. But if there is fire and the smoke has become so thick making re-entry impossible, then we can't save the ones who remain in their streets. Horrible."